cheese!
Now you're next to see something wild. Something wacky. Something green. It's the Muppets.
Oh, wow.
And they can be yours to keep on video.
I shall accept nothing.
So hold on tight for a video adventure that's unlike any other.
Wonderful.
Spectacular.
Because they're larger than life. They're the Muppets.
What?
I said the Muppets.
You are all weirdos.
Okay, stand by. Here we go.
Kermit and the irrepressible Miss Piggy are heading to Hollywood in the Muppet movie.
Oh, you Hollywood!
That's always been my dream.
Come share this unforgettable adventure.
Whoopee!
Don't miss out on all the outrageous fun in the Muppet movie.
That'll be all for now.
Get in on the hilarious fun as the Muppets turn London upside down in the Great Muppet Caper.
Miss
Piggy has been framed.
Free Miss Piggy, we'll get you out of this.
And only Kermit, Gonzo and Fozzie can prove she's innocent.
Those clowns?
I'll be stuck in the big house for life.
It's a jolly good time, the Great Muppet Caper.
That took a lot out of me.
Join our distinguished host.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here.
And some very wild life.
Roar! Roar! That is what we really do best.
In the Muppet Sing-Alongs.
Do you like to sing?
Yeah!
Oh, good. Then come and join us. That's great. I really love that song.
So tap along and rap along. Have fun with the Muppets Sing-Along, starring Billy Bunny.
So much fun, we don't want to stop it.
You sounded good, too. Are you sure you're not a frog?
The Muppets on video. Once you start your collection...
Let's go for it.
You won't want to stop.
Very popular choice.
With Kermit, Gonzo and Miss Piggy. And bring home the most outrageous fun your family will ever have.
All right, you tossed me into it.
Started on
the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, motivational. This is what we call a Muppet Show.
Welcome again to the Muppet Show, voted the best show in the world out of all the shows hosted by frogs. But first, an opening number.
Oh no, I can't take any more of your opening numbers.
Come on, guys, what's wrong with them?
They're so weird.
Yeah, what do you have tonight? A Chinese gorilla dancing ballet?
Cancel the opening number. Ladies and gentlemen, our opening number!
Round, round, get around, I get around. Get around, round, round, I get around.
I get around.
To meet your best girl home on a Saturday night.
get around, I get around.
Yeah, get around, round, round, I get around. I get around.
See you around.
What do you think of pigs on bikes?
I never have liked road hogs.
Road hogs!
Kermit?
Yeah?
Oh, Kermit, you know, you and I should have done that number together.
Uh-huh.
You'd be very attractive in the leather and goggle look.
Well, I just need the leather. I already got the goggle look.
Yes. I just love your eyes. Oh, they're like two ping pong balls floating in a pond of green algae.
Must be true. Everybody says the same thing.
I got rhythm. I got rhythm.
Wait a second, Fuzzy. Hold on. Now you're starting wrong. It goes like this. Let me show you. I got rhythm.
Oh, gotcha, gotcha. Okay. I got
gotcha, rhythm. Gotcha. Now.
I got rhythm. I got.
No. Fozzie, hold on a second. Let me make one little change here. Okay, I'll sing it.
Yes, sir. I don't got rhythm. I don't got rhythm. I don't got rhythm.
Who could ask for anything more?
We could.
Yeah, earplugs. Who could ask for anything more?
Reports are coming in from all over the world that television news reporters are blowing up. These unlikely rumors have... Ladies and gentlemen, Calypso time!
Big, 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 having fun. Dancing, singing in the sun. You're a big, big, come and dance. Tell us of your hair romance.
All day long I sit around, dreaming of the love I found, because I really love my frog, and when I love, I go whole hog.
Big, 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 having fun. Dancing, singing in the sun. You're the big, come and dance. Tell us of your girl.
Is the reason why I have this twinkle in my eye. Kermit, Kermit, shy and cute. How I love that handsome brute.
Big, 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 having fun. Dancing, singing in the sun. You're old Kermit, come and dance. Tell us of your gay romance.
Frog has come to have his say. The pig will never get her way. Bib and napkin, knife and fork is the only way that I'll touch pork.
I like the steel drums.
What?
The pig steel drums.
I believe it. They take anything that's not nailed down.
Hey, Kermit, me and the band gonna play at the wedding?
What wedding?
Well, I just heard the news that you and Miss Fatback was gonna tie the knot and raise chitlins.
Biggie! Kermit, it's just a joke.
A joke? People want to think we're really engaged.
It's so sweet sounding when you say it.
Well, the engagement is off.
Dear sweetheart, it's not like that. It's like this.
On stage for the next number.
Mm-hmm.
Manamana. Manamana. Manamana.
Just a second. It's for you.
Manamana.
The question is, what is a manamana?
The question is, who cares?
How would you like to boogie?
Well then, get thee to a barnyard.
Woo-hoo.
In the barnyard pen.
Quack, quack.
Said the duck, won't you let me in?
Cluck, cluck, cluck.
Said the little white hen,
let's boogie in the barnyard.
Bye, bye.
Said the sheep, promenade off home.
Moo, moo.
Said the cow, let the butter roll.
Cluck, cluck, cluck.
Say the little white hen,
let's boogie in the barnyard.
Well, the barnyard would jump in, everybody having to fling.
Even old McDonald had to do a little corny swing.
Wow, wow.
Said the dog in the circus talk.
Meow.
Said the cat, now please don't stop.
Clock, clock, clock.
Said the little white hen,
let's boogie in the barnyard.
Take it.
Don't boogie in the barnyard.
Very good, barnyard animals. Nicely mooed, oinked, and clucked.
What about me?
Okay. Bah.
I thought it was good.
Out, 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 out. I hate cheap shots.
Kermit, already so. Let us go to the circus. With the greatest of ease, the daring young frog on the flying trapeze.
I don't know how she gets me into these things.
Are you ready, Kermit?
Yeah. Just don't push me hard.
What?
Push me hard.
Okay.
Yeah, I think so. I'm just a little woozy, that's all.
Oh, Kermit.
Close the curtains!
Yes!
Wow, what a terrific act. Do you want a partner?
Oh, Kermit! Gonzo, get him backstage.
Ah, don't worry, it's all part of the act. Is there a doctor in the house?
Time once again for Veterinarian's Hospital, the continuing story of a quack who's gone to the dogs.
Well, Nurse Janice, who's the next patient?
We'll see for yourself, Dr. Bob.
Oh, it's Kermit! My Kermit!
Take it easy. I'm okay.
Quiet. This is a very dramatic moment.
Kermit, I shall nurse you back to health if it takes a lifetime.
What do you think's wrong with him, Dr. Bob?
Well, for one thing, he's been badly exposed to overacting. Either that or overexposed to bad acting.
I am not acting. I love him.
Nurse Piggy, you cannot let your personal feelings affect your duty. You are a nurse.
I may be a nurse, but I'm a woman first.
Wrong. You're a pig first. Nurse second. I don't think woman made the top 10.
Dr. Bob!
Oh, he's all right. It just looks like he was under heavy sedation.
Well, he was under heavy sedation. A 50-pound box of sleeping pills fell on his head.
It did not.
Well, I know, but it's my only joke.
poor Kermit.
Well, he's still breathing, but I think his pulse is weak.
Kermit, can you hear me? This is Nurse Piggy. I will never leave your side till you have taken your last breath. Do you think he heard me?
He must have. His pulse has stopped.
If anything happens to him, you will have me to account to.
Good. I was wondering who was going to pay his bill.
And so we come to the end of another Veterinarian's Hospital. Tune in next week when you'll hear Kermit say...
Let me out of here. I want to get out of here.
No, Kermit, no, don't. No, stay here where it's safe.
Did you see that?
Yes, the frog is certainly taking a beating on this show.
It's hard to feel sorry for him. We take a beating every show.
Ladies and gentlemen, although our beloved Kermit has been seriously injured...
Wait. What's seriously injured? I twisted a flipper.
Go back. Although he has a severely twisted flipper, he is going to go on with the show. Yes. Here he is, our own Kermit the Frog in...
A hospital bed.
A hospital bed?
He bought a coconut, he bought it for a dime. His nephew had another one, he paid it for a lime. He put the lime in the coconut, he drank them both up. He put the lime in the coconut, drank them both up. He put the lime in the coconut, drank them both up. He put the lime in the coconut. He called the doctor, woke him up and said,
"Doctor, ain't there nothing I can take?" I say, "Doctor, to relieve this flipper ache." I said, "Doctor, ain't there nothing I can take?" I say, "Doctor, to relieve this flipper ache."
Now let me get this straight. You put the lime in the coconut, you drank them both up. You put the lime in the coconut, you drank them both up.
You put the lime in the coconut, he drank them both up.
You put the lime in the coconut, you call your doctor, woke him up. Said, "Doctor, ain't there nothing I can take?" I said, "Doctor,
to relieve this flipper ache. I said, doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, doctor, to relieve this flipper ache. You put the lime in the coconut, you drank them both together. Put the lime in your coconut, then you feel better. Put the lime in the coconut, you drank them both. Put the lime in your coconut and call me in the morning.
The froggy bought a coconut. He had another one. His nephew had another one. He paid him for a line. He put the lime in the coconut. He drank them both up. He put the lime in the coconut. He called the doctor, woke him up, said, doctor, is there nothing I can take? I said, doctor, do you need this flipper ache? I said, doctor, is there nothing I can take? I said, doctor, you put the lime in the coconut. He drank them both up. He put the lime in the coconut.
If you call me in the morning, I'll tell you what to do.
Ever gone to a witch doctor?
They're all witch. Ever heard of a poor doctor? Now this Muppet news flash. Muppet Labs has just announced that they are recalling their latest model hospital bed used in the Lime and Coconut production number. The beds were built on an assembly line formerly used for pop-up toasters.
Yegor spur de oogity skidoo. Ye born de her de erp. Mork, mork, mork. Oogity spurn de her bevorn de chocolate. Mmm. Is burn de her de chocolate. Mmm. Yum, yum, yum. With the chocolate. Is burn de whom? Good, good chocolate, or no, the moose. Moose, moose, yeah, the moose. Yeah, home, and good. The chocolate, or the moose.
Kermit, if you need me, I'll be in Camilla's dressing room.
Oh, Camilla, Camilla the chicken?
Suppose I get so excited that I faint.
Gonzo, I just don't know. I suppose she'll have to give you mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
She'll have to what?
Or in your case, mouth-to-beak resuscitation. Gonzo, are you okay?
Of course. I was just rehearsing my faint.
I hope Camilla's been rehearsing hers.
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. The hip hooray and ballyhoo. The lullaby of Broadway.
The rumble of the subway train.
A-ding-a-ding.
The rattle of the taxi. The daffodils to entertain. And Angelo's and Maxi.
When a Broadway baby says goodnight,
it's early in the morning.
And babies don't sleep tight until the dawn.
This is 42nd Street.
Listen to the lullaby.
weird. Why did they want the igloo?
What?
Why did they want the igloo?
Well, maybe someone broke their egg.
This is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the planet Coosbane, and today I'm interviewing a most unfortunate creature, the Coosbanian Thief.
Thank you, thank you. I'm pleased to be here. As a matter of fact, I'm pleased to be anywhere.
I can believe that, because you see, folks, the foob is known as the most delicious creature on Coosbane.
That's true. We have a saying on this world. I never met a foob I didn't like, especially with mushroom gravy.
I suppose this tends to hold down the foob population pretty effectively?
Not really. Actually, my species is flourishing.
Really? Well, how do you manage that?
Evolution.
I don't think I understand.
We foobs tend to evolve rather faster than most creatures.
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you evolve into?
Oh, you know, whatever's handy.
I beg your pardon?
We try to blend in with the crowd as best we can.
Say, are you changing?
Evolving. Evolving is the accurate term.
Yeah, but you're starting to look familiar.
I should certainly hope so.
This is very weird. Good grief. Even your clothes are the same.
It's called the survival of the trench-coated.
But you can't do this. Oh, this is Kermit the Frog returning you to... I'm Kermit the Frog! I am!
It's me! Camilla, my apricot! These are for you! Oh, gosh. I think the room is spinning. I may faint. Ah! How was that? Camilla, aren't you going to kiss me? Oh, great. Just my luck. A chicken with hay fever.
Hi.
Hello yourself.
Remember me, Mickey Moose?
How can I forget?
You don't have to get touchy about it.
Excuse me, perchance have you seen a Mickey Moose around?
Who wants to know?
Ronald Duck.
Ronald Duck and Mickey Moose? Would you guys get out of here? Come on, out!
There's a far, far better moose and duck to fly before you.
And now, Pigs in Space!
Starring the indomitable Captain Link Hogthrob, the flappable first mate, Miss Piggy, and the inexplicable Dr. Strangeport.
When last we left the spaceship Swine Trek, it had developed a severe list.
Do something!
Well, I can't correct it. There's something wrong with the gyroscopic... What do you call it, Dr. Strangeport?
I don't know, but if it isn't fixed, it'll sure louse up our billiard game tonight.
Right.
Maybe I can fix it.
You?
Yes. Fixed it.
But all you did was sit in Link's seat.
Maybe it took a woman's touch.
It's working, isn't it, gentlemen?
Yes, it is. Okay, let me back in my own seat here, then.
Excuse me. Oh, wait. Oh, no.
It's doing it again.
Right. First mate Piggy, come here, please.
Why?
Just come here.
All right. Watch it. What is it?
Link, I think we found the answer.
Oh?
It's a coincidence, Strangeport.
Oh, yeah? Then why don't you go back to your own seat?
Oh, I think I will. Uh-oh.
Hey, I get it now.
One word from you, Long Lips, and you're dead.
As you wish, First Mate Fatso.
Fatso! That does it!
Get her away from me.
Ladies and gentlemen, come
here. Now me, please.
Yes, now.
Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, due to an overwhelming demand from him, if not from the rest of us, here is our own furry funny man, Fozzie Bear.
Hey, thank you, and thank you. Yes, tonight, because there is a certain someone special in the audience, hi, Ma, I will do a special act. Phrenology.
Phren what?
And for this demonstration, I will need a volunteer.
What? Fozzie, what are you going to do?
Trust me, it's for my mother. Okay, gang. Phrenology. The art of reading a person's fortune by feeling the bumps on his head.
What?
Okay, now, here we go. Well, I can tell you're a very flexible person.
Fozzie.
Yes, okay, here we go. I can see in your future, tomorrow, you will have a stiff neck. Oh, yes, okay.
You're gonna get another job tomorrow, too, I tell you that.
Please do it for Mom.
Yes,
okay,
yes.
Here we go. Bumps.
Mother.
You got some nice bumps, Frog. Bumps.
Wonderful.
Gee, except your bumps for intelligence are very small.
What?
Yeah. That's okay. I can fix that.
You're gonna do what?
Yeah.
Ah!
You will notice.
Spazzy, will you listen to me?
Honeydew here at Muppet Labs, where the future is being made today. Well, I've got some news of welcome relief to short, stubbly people like Beaker here. Announcing new Muppet Labs atomic elevator shoes. Yes, these shoes can add inches to your height at the mere flick of a lever. Beaker is wearing them now, and they work like this. Up. Down. Oh, Beaker, stop it! You're just acting like a baby. And so the atomic elevator shoe adds untold inches to Beaker's unfortunate physique. Beaker, you never told me you wore stripy socks. That's all for today from Muppet Labs.
Demonstrate my amazing powers of hypnosis. I shall place a member of the audience in a trance, aided only by the mysterious strength of hypnotic suggestion. My subject will support with only one hand this 5,000-pound weight. Who will be the first lucky volunteer? Well, it's just a question of mind over matter.
That's right. You don't mind and we don't matter.
You'll live to regret this.
We intend to.
I just don't understand you people. Immortality is up for grabs. But you don't deserve it.
No, but you do.
What a terrific idea. I'll hypnotize myself. I'll go down in history. Look deep into my eyes. Make my mind a complete blank. My eyelids are getting heavy. I am falling into my power. When I count three, I will have the strength of an army. One, two, three. The ropes!
That's very impressive, but how do you get out of it?
It's simple! I just snap my fingers! Hey, Kermit! It went terrific!
He says it went terrific, but I know how he really feels.
How's that?
About so high. You will all be happy to know that Gonzo did survive that last act and is about to embark on a new career as a lump. But right now it's time for our closing number. Are we ready back there?
Who wants to know?
I do.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, boss. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the last one in is a sissy.
To be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade. He let us in, knows where we've been in his octopus's garden in the shade. I'd ask my friends to come and see an octopus's garden. In an octopus's garden in the shade.
We would be warm.
Hello, Mr. Arm.
In our little hideaway beneath the waves. Resting our head on the seabed. In an octopus's garden near a cave. We would sing and dance around.
In an octopus's garden in the shade.
different.
Did you like it?
No.
Then it wasn't different.
Well, that's just about the end of another magical Muppet medley of mirth and misery.
All right, Frog, we watched the show.
Yeah, unlock the doors.
Something wonderful happens.
What?
It ends.